incredibly important. Family is very important, and I think that within the family, the role that my mother has certainly played in my upbringing, in I feel the level of confidence that I have today, a true feeling that the world is at my feet. I'm aware of my limitations also, which I'm thankful for. And again, that's a certain grounding that you get an education from school and you get an education at home. And both of those are invaluable. And one of the things that I learned at home and from my mother was the value of education as a whole and how that was very important before you do anything. So whatever you want to do with your life, whatever you want to become when you grow up, first you must complete your education to, as you know, certainly up until a bachelor's degree. After that, I was insistent that I wanted to do a master's degree, mainly because I didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. I hadn't decided what my career should be. So my parents, and especially my mother, when it came to education, was something that she was very passionate about. I think her whole family has been passionate about education for many years. So that was has been instilled in us. And there was never any distinction between my brother and myself when it came to what we wanted to do. And parenting is something that is so complicated. I can't imagine being a parent. And you can really, you shape a young child. And that's a huge responsibility. I think I turned out quite well. And I suppose I do have to give my mother a lot of credit for that.
Well, thank you, Soha. You know, that's what I said, that please ask her what she thought about my parenting. So I'm glad. But yes, taking from her, I would say that education is one single most important thing. And I think we, both my husband and I, just valued that. And we felt that if we had to give our children the best of education and aage whatever decision they want to take, just create options, because the education empowers. Education opens up the whole world in front of you. With education, you can deal with success, you can deal with failures. You become a person. You are not indebted, or you're not, nobody can manipulate you. Nobody can take education away from you. You can lose money, you can be rich today, you can be poor tomorrow. But if you're educated, you remain educated. It's something that is there forever. So I think we valued it, my parents valued it, my mother gave us that confidence. We don't have a brother. I had only two other sisters. So we do, you know, they didn't make us feel that sons were important. And they gave us equal opportunity. They gave us the best that they could afford. And we felt that we should also give our children a good education. And the rest is their destiny and what they make of that. So to that extent, we prioritized education. Ji, वैसे हमने सोचा था कि she would follow an academic career. पहले तो Ford Foundation में काम कर रही थी in the developmental field. तो हमने सोचा था उसके बाद she started working with Citibank. Then we thought maybe she's changed her mind and she's going to do some. Then she started, you know, showing interest for working in films. And her first film was a Bengali film, which I was quite happy about, being a Bengali. And so, yes, I mean, we didn't expect it, but we were supportive. We felt, like she herself said, that you have given me the education, you've given me the exposure, you've created that option, now I want to exercise that option. So I said, yes, definitely, you have to exercise the option. I can't say that, yes, do this and don't do that. So, zarur, we didn't expect it, but we were very supportive. We didn't expect Saif also to go into the film, because they were kept away from films completely. But that's what they chose, and we were supportive.
It's been 10 years since I chose to work in films. I remember not telling her, because I was terrified of what my parents' reaction would be. And one thing I wanted to do more than anything else was to always make them proud. And I felt that because of my extensive education, that they perhaps wanted me to do something else. And one of the questions that I'm faced with most, which I've always said is such a ridiculous question, is that if you were going to be an actress, why did you study so much? And I've always thought that that was such a silly question, because an education is surely more than a means to a job. It's an end in itself. And it really has contributed, my education, into making me who I am. When I went to Oxford, it wasn't about learning history. I can't remember 5 history dates, but I learned how to, you know, balance a checkbook, how to make friends with people from all over the world, how to represent my country, how to, you know, operate a washing machine, how to cook, how to catch a bus. So there were so many things that I learned, and I discovered so many things about myself. So I think that this is my third profession. One of the wonderful things about an education and that support system at home, which really enables you to be the best that you can be and try out different things without judgment. And that's something that I'm grateful for what I received from my family and from my school and the schooling that I got, was that I've been able to take chances that if Ford Foundation was something that I got a lot of satisfaction from, I wanted to then try what it was like to do investment banking. I did that for 1.5 years and realized that that wasn't something that I enjoyed. But I've always enjoyed acting and theater, so let me try films. So again, there was no judgment at home, which is something that I'm grateful for. The world may judge you, and the press and the media may judge you, but I think if you have a secure, non-judgmental schooling system and a family system and people who encourage you to really try out things and be the best that you can be, then that's something that's very special. And I would want that for all the young girls out there.
Absolutely. Amma, she just got some toast for me. She thought I should eat because I was wilting with hunger.
ऐसे छोटी-छोटी चीजें जब मुझे लगता है कि अम्मा अभी मैं आपको बताऊंगी नहीं उनकी उम्र क्या है क्योंकि बहुत करीब बैठी हैं तो लेकिन obviously I feel very protective और मैं चाहती हूँ कि वो comfortable रहे उनको पानी की ज़रूरत है या अभी हम press conference कर रहे हैं तो you know will she be okay तो I feel लेकिन वो खुद इतनी मजबूत हैं और हमेशा से इतनी इंडिपेंडेंट रही हैं और उनके पसंद इतने फर्म और बन चुके हैं अब तक तो मैं जब छोटी थी हम स्कूल ट्रिप्स पे जाते थे और हमेशा मैं अम्मा के लिए या तो जब हम आगरा जाते थे तो एक ताजमहल मैं खरीदती थी या हम उदयपुर गए तो मैंने कुछ हैंडीक्राफ्ट या कुछ सैलेड का कुछ फॉक और नाइफ खरीदा था एंड शी वुड वेरी हैप्पीली एक्सेप्ट इट एंड देन पुट इट अवे एंड आई वुड नेवर सी इट अगेन सो देन आई क्विकली रियलाइज्ड दैट शी knows what she likes. So I try, actually, हमेशा हर साल लंदन जाते हैं अभी अगले महीने जाएंगे और वहाँ पे ऑफ कोर्स हमें यहाँ पे घर में बहुत सपोर्ट स्टाफ मिलता है वहाँ पे नहीं मिलती है तो देन आई एम अवेयर ऑफ हाउ आई कैन हेल्प एंड आई कैन हेल्प कैरी ग्रोसरीज एंड यू नो दैट्स वेयर आई कैन बी ऑफ असिस्टेंस अदरवाइज शी इज़ रियली वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड
इंडिपेंडेंट शी मेड मी अ पार्ट ऑफ यू नो ऑल हर स्पेशल फर्स्ट्स You know, like whether her first day in school, first day in college, first day of anything. So, you know, it's very special that she includes us in everything. So I think it's nice to be wanted by your children and, you know, they share their happiness and their feelings with you. So I think to that extent, I feel very fortunate. Now, in the moment you say that, I just go blank. Because I think it's, you know, every day, these little things that that are always there. And whenever I have to make a decision, I mean, for instance, she's going to teach me how to do Skype, for instance. Huh. She's going to put that in for me. Like when I said I can't do SMSs, she says, of course, Amma, you can. And she taught me in 5 minutes because she's a very... patient and a good teacher. My other daughter scolds me too much. And she says, you know, so I just can't do it. I get nervous. But whereas she is patient and she teaches me and I learn it very well. So there are these give and takes continuously. There are certain things that she knows much better than I do. And she does it very quickly and without fuss, and which helps me. So I often ask her advice and ask her if I'm in two minds, and now the tiger is not there, I often ask Soha that what should I do? Should I do this or should I do that?
And, in December last year, 6 months back, I built my studio. And it's been 6 months now that I've been functioning in that studio. And this is my first work out from the studio. We were discussing with Arun. It's a great vastu for me that it started. It's starting off with such great cause, And I'm so honored and so proud to be associated with a cause like this and Clinic Plus' great initiative and movement for the child education, girl child education especially. And today, whatever I am today, wherever I've reached today, the entire credit goes to my mother from the childhood till whatever age I am today and whatever success I have achieved. That entire credit goes to my mother, who is a woman, and my wife. And they are she's here. And it's a fundamental right of women to have this education. And I'm so proud to be associated with this. And I really thank Arun for actually calling me for this, compose the jingle for this. And another reason was being associated with Gulzar Saab, who has written such beautiful words, such beautiful lyrics, which has, just by reading the words like dar faldar hai, kuch patne dona, beti honar hai, aur padne dona, bas ek saal aur. Just by reading those lines, it just evokes the feeling, those emotions inside you, that you want to compose a beautiful tune. And the best person I had was Kavita Singh, who is mother of two, herself. And yeah, that's how the song happened.
जब अमित ने बुलाया इस सॉन्ग के बारे में बताया तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा कि एक औरत होने के नाते और इस कॉज से मैं जुड़ रही हूँ तो इससे बेहतरीन कोई बात नहीं हो सकती. और हमेशा ही वुमेन राइट्स को लेके बहुत मैं काफ़ी पजेसिव रही हूँ और कुछ भी बात होती है तो मुझे लगता नहीं हमको ये चाहिए वो चाहिए, काफ़ी घर में भी पंगे लेती रहती थी. तो बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे कि मैं इस कॉज के साथ जुड़ रही हूँ. और एक शायद हम लोग एक आर्टिस्ट होने के नाते अपनी म्यूज़िक के द्वारा या अपनी आर्ट के द्वारा ही सोसाइटी की सेवा कर सकते हैं, तो मुझे लगा इससे बेहतरीन मौका और कोई नहीं हो सकता. दैट्स व्हाई आई वाज पार्ट ऑफ दिस सॉन्ग एंड क्रेडिट गोज़ टू अमित, अ ब्यूटीफुल कंपोजिशन. आई
सेड इट्स सच एन ऑनर टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस कैंपेन. इट्स नॉट एवरी डे इन एडवर्टाइजिंग दैट यू गेट टू मेक अ विजिबल डिफरेंस लाइक दिस. एंड आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल टू द टीम एट यूनिलीवर फॉर हैविंग मेड अस अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस. एंड it was pretty personal for all of us. So, you know, it's something that everybody in the team at Lintas, at Unilever, felt for this. And the simple thought where we came from was that every mother dreams that her daughter should have a better life than her, than she did. So just stemming from that, if that is what she wants, she needs to show a lot of resolve, a lot of strength today for that to happen. And if that she shows today, it's going to pay back in a very big way for her, for society. So that's where Maa Se Maa, Maa Se Mazbooti happened. And then Gulzar sir happened. And then Amit Trivedi happened. And then Gauri, who's not here, who directed the ad, happened. So all of it happened. It's just, it's still...
Then happened magic.
Yeah, it's just people came together and then all of this is happening. So it's just very, very nice. And we genuinely, from the bottom of our heart, wish that it does make a difference. So. Thank you.